Hello, hello. What do we have here? Today, I'm going to show you some props and some weird tricks that I know. And already I'm itching my face. So, look what I have here. I have the floating cup. But look. Oh. Let me show you what I'm actually doing here. But first, I want you to focus on this cup. Just focus as it spins around like this. And here's what I'm doing. I'm just letting one finger go. One finger is always making contact from the back, and one from the front. And you're probably thinking, why is he showing me this trick with the cup? Well, I'm going to be doing the same thing with two other props. And by showing you this with the cup, and you seeing what I'm doing, it will make you less confused about what's happening with the other objects. And by doing this, well, by having this cup, it has writing on it. It's from Wawa, which is a store around, well, it's on the East Coast. And the writing on this cup gives it sort of a glimpse so that it looks less confusing than the other two objects. So I'm going to go real slow here. Real slow. Wobble it. I like doing like a wobbling, floating. Alright. So now, I'm going to do it with this here. Ooh, I'm actually not doing it correctly because I'm so out of practice. I used to do this thing, which is called contact juggling. And there's a lot of little moves that you can learn. Watch. I've gotten so bad at it, but it's a little too fast, I think, for ASMR stuff. So I'm just going to go real slow with it like this. Although I guess ASMR stuff works fast. After all, there's somebody called Fast ASMR. Actually, I've seen a lot of her stuff. She's pretty good. But I don't know if that's my personal favorite. So again, I'm showing you this ball. I need more practice hiding my fingers. And here's something you've probably seen that's a little more familiar, if you're familiar with contact juggling. Yes, the. So I thought this would be kind of cool because you might be able to see what's in front of the ball. You can see a little bit of the screen, and you can sort of see the camera that I've set up here. Alright. I'm kind of moving through these things a little quicker than I thought. Let us opening up this case here. And in this case, let me see if I have what I remember. So I have just some lockpick tools and one of these little practice locks. And I think, let's see if I can get this. Actually, I'm just kind of violent when I do that. I'm trying to like pick a lock and hoping that I'm successful here. Oh, there we go. I haven't done that in a little while. So I figured the clickiness would be kind of cool, but again, I'm just moving through these things a little faster than I thought I would. So maybe I have fewer props than expected. Hey, look what I have here. A really worn out Rubik's Cube. I've had this thing for like more than a decade. Yeah, more than a decade. And the orange, I had to like put little pieces of tape on to mark it. So I'm just gonna like, I'm using the microphone on my headset as my main microphone. I don't have anything fancy. So hopefully, there's a little bit of clickiness happening here. Now I'm gonna see if I can actually do this still. So I think I can. Alright. So I'm gonna first solve the green. And I get a line here. Get a cross. So I have a cross, but it's not the cross I want because the sides are not, the middle supposed to be matching up, so I have to fix that. And that's not too hard to fix. Now I have a good one. See, that matches. And that, whoop, nope. There we go. Alright. Let's do this thing. So, I'm gonna try to talk while I'm doing this. But, I don't want to move too quickly here. But I tend to move pretty quickly when I'm doing this. Now I've got a green side like this. Now we're going to do the second layer. Funny thing is, if I don't end up doing this successfully, I'm not going to actually end the video. But hey, I got two layers, and sometimes trouble. I might have to come back to this. Alright, I'm gonna actually solve that shortly. Let me move to this weird chain thing that I don't know where it's from. I have no idea where I got this, but it's like, oh, it looks like a chandelier chain. So we got a little bit of jingling. I gotta do something where, like, it's really predictable. I'm just gonna lay this down into my hand very slowly. Okay, I am really frustrated that I messed up this Rubik's Cube thing, so I'm going to go, I'm going to go, like, really serious mode on it, because, yeah. Alright, here we go. I'm going to try to do this for realies now. Oh, that's what I wanted to do. Okay. Things are looking a little bit better now. Okay, that's right. That's wrong. Okay, here we go. Oh, I got this now. I got this. There it is. I had to remember, I haven't done this in a few years. Okay, back to the chain. My frustration with that Rubik's Cube is finished. I don't know how to make this chain relaxing, I just thought it would be a cool thing. Really slow, drop the chain into my hand. Like this. Oh, this might be loud, but oh yeah, I don't want to do that. That's too crazy. Okay. So that's all I can think of right now. I just wanted to make a video where I did some really cool things. So if you think that any of these triggers were relaxing at all, which I don't even know if they're triggers. I don't think I've seen anybody do any of the things I just did, and somehow I decided to do this. If you think any of that stuff is relaxing, let me know, and I can try doing more things like it. But right now I'm just experimenting, since I don't usually do live stuff like this. I do this a lot on VRChat. that's it for now. Bye.